Here we have Aishwarya, PMP, who cleared PMP recently. And congratulations, Aishwarya, for clearing this wonderful certification, the most toughest one. And also I found that while preparing, it was not tough for you. You started scoring 70, 75%, very normal in most of the practice exams. So there is a good amount of commitment and good amount of, involvement in this preparation from you. So happy for that. Good wishes from Sri Lanka.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll be so happy to listen from you. How is your journey? What is your background in sense? What kind of work you do and how is it later? So if you give some idea, it may help some people who are preparing for it.
Yeah, sure, Sriram. Yeah, thank you very much. So I would first of all say thanks very much to Sri Learning for shaping me in the right direction, because when I first started to think about doing PMP, I was not very confident. I was kind of skeptical about whether I should go for PMP given the scenario and all this stuff. But actually, if you remember, I contacted you in the month of April or May, and then you were saying like July it is going to change the syllabus, and then fortunately it didn't change and I got an opportunity to again try till December. So I thought, let's give it a try. And even Rahul, right, when I contacted him regarding the program, he was also very supportive, saying application processing and everything is not a big deal at all. It's just a matter of filling the application. We'll take care of everything from the beginning to end. So I was confident and started Sri Learning enrollment. And it was one of the best decision I took regarding clearing PMP. So to start off with the study plan, right? So initially, I didn't read any books before coming to the Sri Learning and all. I just attended the training with a blank state of mind. And the classes, as it just went on, I just observed whatever was taught in the class by Sriram. It was all with real-time examples as well as real-time workshop where we get to work with the team members regarding the stakeholder meetings and all that planning for the project work. So all those classes, I got an idea about what project planning is about, what a project is, and how we should not be stuck inside our own routine of our own company's project practices. So that's not just the end of the world. So just it gave me a perspective to open up my mind and come out of the narrow mindset which we have while working in the company as a business analyst. So for me, I was a business analyst and I work as a business analyst with around 7 years experience. So I had to unlearn few things and learn many new things in terms of project management. And in terms of learning, right, so I would say I just attended the class, and after the class was over, I started looking through the notes which I made while the class was going on, and that itself gave a good amount of clarity on the basic concepts which I need to know. All those foundation and basics I got to know from the class only, all the class notes which I had and all the materials shared. So once I done with those things, it took, so my class ended on June 23rd or around. So from July, I started reading. So I was not very up to the pace of starting the learning in the June itself. So I just started my learning only after June end, after the class was over. So I started reading Rita first, and I just read through all the chapters one by one. Not a serious deep dive reading, but rather I just glanced through the chapters and I read the concepts and I tried to make myself understand the concepts first. So I didn't try to memorize any ITTOs or anything. I just understood how the ITTO was used actually to perform that process. So In that way, I was taking around 2 days for each chapter, and I completed around 15 to 20 days, I completed Rita. And after Rita, I started to do the mocks. Actually, I do the mocks given by the Sri Learning, Udemy mocks. I just did those. I was getting around 60%. So I thought like maybe my skill has to improve a bit. So I started to think about going for PMBOK. So initially, people were having some mindset like PMBOK is very hard. You shouldn't go for PMBOK. Only Rita is enough. But I personally feel that PMBOK is actually very much good and has in-depth knowledge. It's not that complex if you read it after reading Rita. So once you finish Rita, we have to go for PMBOK. And in PMBOK also, I just went chapter by chapter. So I tried for 5 chapters. I did a very deep reading. But after that, I didn't have the patience to read that deep into PMBOK. I just wanted to clear the exams soon because I was feeling like I was giving too much importance to reading in depth. So I just skimmed through some of the chapters, the last 2 chapters especially, I just skimmed through the topics. And afterwards, I was thinking I should maybe go for the PrepCast mock test. And before that PrepCast mock test itself, I was making sure that I completed all the Udemy mocks given by Sri Learning. And also this chapter-wise question and answers, all those materials which were given by Sri Lanka, that I covered. And only after that, I took the PrepCast. So that was around 15th of August only, I bought the PrepCast. And in the matter of 15 days, I had 2 weeks away for my exam. So I scheduled my exam on 31st of August. So I completed PrepCast all the 7 mocks within like 10 to 12 days. So I was taking one mock each day, and review also I took around 8 hours for each mock. So from preparation standpoint, I would say that initially we have to be reading the Rita book once, and then PIMBOK for deeper understanding. And after that, to get confidence with the timing and how the pace of the exam, because it's a 4-hour exam, we need to have that mental stability to actually sit and write for 4 hours. I didn't have that patience in me. So I used to, even for mock exam, I used to finish in 2.5 or 3 hours maximum, because I was thinking like, I didn't have the patience literally to sit for 4 hours and read each and every question very deeply. So I'll read the question. I'm naturally a fast reader a bit, because I used to read a lot of books. So I used to read fast all the questions. If I didn't know a question, I didn't use to stop on it. Rather, I'll just skip the question to the next thing. So that way, I was able to complete even the mock exams in Udemy or be it PrepCast. I was able to complete it within 3 hours maximum. Was 3 hours I took. So in that way, when I did the mock, right, I got the confidence that I can complete the exam within like the 4 hour exam didn't look so stressful for me. I was able to gain confidence that I can sit through the exam first of all. So that mental stability I got after giving the mock test. So I would suggest that first we have to give enough mock test for us to mentally prepare ourselves for the exam. That is the main thing. Even though we study a lot, but still if you're not able to sit for 4 hours and give the exam, that will not make sense. So we have to first practice so much mock.
But amazingly, you did your whole PMP exam in 2 hours 45 minutes, right? That's the time you did?
Yeah. Yeah, that was because mock exam I practiced in the same time actually. I used to do it in 2.5 hours, so like that I used to do.
That's a crazy speed. I always see that you practice exams, you score 80, but you will tell a computer in 2.5 hours. See what she's doing. Yeah. There are people for 4 hours they take to write 180 questions. But for you, 2.5 hours.
Yeah, it all depends on the speeding, speed of reading. Yeah, so it's not like just because I read fast doesn't mean that I have some edge or something. But yes, some people may take some time to read. That's also not bad. But if you're able to sit for 4 hours, then that is fine, well and fine. But for that, to sit for 4 hours, we need to have that mental stability to actually sit.
Yeah, you're right. And tell me, did you went with the proctor-based exam or center exam? How was the feeling?
So I went for center-based exam because I had not a good internet connection in my home. So I even for the mock exam, I faced 2 times power cuts and lost 2 chances simply. So I didn't want to take chances. That's why I booked center-based exam. And a center-based exam, actually, I felt it is more better and comfortable than the proctor-based for me because of the network connection issue, first of all, one thing. And also, it gives a feel of that exam center feel where you don't have the distraction or anything.
Yeah.
So, the center-based was good.
Atmosphere. We need that atmosphere.
Yeah. And very also, good. Yeah. And also, in the center-based exam, the screen and monitor was a very big screen. So, that the look and the ambience was good. Even the ergonomics, everything was good there. Pin drop silence and all the system monitor, everything is good.
Yeah, but you have to wear the mask, right, when the exam is good.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, I had to wear, but I didn't feel that much uncomfortable because now it has become a norm, right? Everywhere we have to wear mask and go. It has become a norm kind of thing.
Without mask, it will be uncomfortable going forward.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Good, Aisha. Seriously, so good. We got about the books, we got about the mock exam, we got about the exam day. And how was it on the exam questions? Was it a bigger one or a smaller one? How the concepts were?
Yeah, for me, I got a short answer, the short questions only. Like I have only 2-3 lines questions only for all the questions. And I would say most of the questions I was able to do because I got the idea behind that by doing the mock in PrepCast. So all the PrepCast mocks, when you review each and every one of the questions, so I strongly suggest that you review all the question and answers, whatever you answer in all the PrepCast mocks. It will take a lot of time and it's also very painstaking effort to do that, but we have to do that. Otherwise, we won't get the knowledge what we want to get. So PrepCast, if you read, that actually, it complements the PIMBOK. So even PIMBOK, I left some of the chapters, but when I read PrepCast answers and reviewed them, it actually completed all the PIMBOK concepts also. So when I reviewed all the PIMBOK answers, I made notes of all the 7 mocks, answers and questions. I made a note of it, all the important points. And in the exam point of view, when I faced the questions, I feel that around 30 to 40% of the questions are actually based on PrepCast mock questions. The concept-wise, I would say concept-wise, they are taken the basic concepts, the questions from the PEPCAST type of questions. For example, if you say control charts or tornado diagram, the way they used to word those questions, right? Actually, it was similar to the one they have worded in the PEPCAST. So that when I saw it second time, I was able to relate. Actually, this question is related to tornado diagram because it speaks the same language as the PEPCAST question type. So that way, it was able to connect me to give the right answers. So by reviewing the PrepCast answers in depth and reading the PMBOK, because all the questions, most of them had a resemblance to the PrepCast questions and the PMBOK terminology and words.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Perfectly. So definitely, we have to read the PrepCast review and also the PMBOK. If you read it once also, it is giving you like more than 60% of the weightage it is getting covered there.
Super. Great. Lot of inputs, Aishwarya. I think many going to follow you on the tips of books, exam questions, preparation. But speed-wise, I think nobody can touch you. They can even see from the way you
present. Some people might be more faster than me. Yeah, not like that.
Okay, yeah. Speed is good. But again, you should have that thought process. Your brain should process faster. It differs. But again, it's a good job from you, Aishwarya. So happy to see that you successfully cleared. Maybe we can see your certificate, the beautiful one. Here it goes. Ah, okay. To get this color, to get this name coming up there, it makes good effort, right? So
Definitely.
We do have a lot of certificates. I do hold a lot of certificates. Even though I have a lot of certificates, whenever I see my PMP, it says, okay, man, it worth the effort there.
At the beginning, I thought like it's not that much going to be difficult or anything. But as the time near the exams, when it came, right, I was actually like, God, I should finish this. It's like even worse than my public exams because it was having so much 200 questions and so much concepts. The PrepCast review itself was literally killing me because from morning 10 o'clock, I used to sit till night 10 o'clock. So those 15 days were actually a kind of very hectic for me mentally.
Having a family, kid around. Yeah. That is great. Good. Superb. Aishwarya, keep shining. I know you are a new opportunity now. Now, let this opportunity give you a lot of growth in your life. And let's PMP be a stepping stone to show and exhibit your leadership skills.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Sriram. Thank you. Thanks. All the best to everyone. Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Have a great time. Thanks for coming up and giving a good tips to us. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye.